would say, thanks everybody for coming. It's a great thing, you know, for everybody to get together and for this event. And it's from such a tragedy as Mark Austin. And I'm very honored to call him my friend. And he was a great guy, great person. And I wish you and the girls all the best. So I can't really say anything good or bad about Keith. I mean, well, not bad. I mean, I can say lots of good about him, but I wasn't around here much when you know, Keith was really his heyday. When Keith moved home from Quebec after the Muron job, I was working for Bill Weld and we were staying together, and Ronnie was working there. And I never saw him, you know, race a whole lot other than one about every other race that winter we were at Greenwood. And years later, I was working with Jimmy Doherty, we were at Rockingham Park, and he came down to race Strikeout in the Romeo Hanover Pace, and I was standing there with Jim, and Keith walked up and said hi to Jimmy. Keith wasn't much for a fancy bag or any of that kind of stuff. He just had a helmet and this color stuff in this helmet. It was kind of a dirty old cold night. And he talked to him, walked away, and some guy walked up and he said to Jim, who's that farmer? So he says, we'll know who he is when he leaves here tonight. And I think he drove six horses and he won all five. And Jim said to the guy, that's that farmer I was talking to earlier. And then and I raced in a lot of places in my life through North America. And everywhere he went, everybody asked, do you know Keith Waples? How's he doing? You know, when he kind of was back off his driving. I always had a Keith Waples story, and a good one. And you know, this is a very deserving honor. He's been nothing but a great ambassador for racing everywhere he's gone as far as racing, you know, opening racetracks. And you know, Joe Hudon says that one time, I think, one of the boys parked Keith or something. He said, don't do that again. He said, he kept us alive for years or something. So, that's the, you know, and that's the great thing about this industry. We have people like that who are well respected. Now, on the other hand, Ronnie, I can stand up here and tell stories all night about him, but I see there's a bunch of kids here. It's mixed company also, but, you know, I kind of pick on him once in a while too, and he picks on me, but I don't want to say too much because I know he's up here later, so either that or we'll leave when I'm done here. But, you know, Hector said something about he always knew he was in the right place at the right time. Well, I didn't want to watch some of those films because I guess he was always behind me. I don't know. they all said what a great driver he was. I never saw much of him. The one that he did meet you and I later was Remember Dallas. I parked the whole way and Ronnie was back there in short grin. And anyway, he beat me at the wire. And I come back in after, it was a big race, it was $600,000 or $700,000 race. And I come back in and Billy Hugg said, what are you doing? I said, well, I thought maybe if I left, you know, the guy would let me go and sit the duel. He said, did you not know he was going to park you the whole way? I said, no. He said, you're the only guy in the tri-state area that didn't. Everybody else was. Anyway, Ronnie won it, and then I had to go celebrate with him afterwards. That was, you know, you go, here I am, I finally won a great race, beat that horse and stuff, and nobody's here to celebrate with you. I said, it's pretty tough for me to sit here all summer. But anyway, I did. But, you know, just, we've had a lot of good times together, traveled a lot together, and there was, I don't know if you all read online, Michael Shantz and Ronnie, they didn't get along the best of most of the time, but well, the last 20 years they had, because they had spoiled prior to that. It was kind of a little argument here, and again, I could never figure out why. But anyway, Mike, he wrote a nice letter, you know, congratulating Keith and stuff on distributing stuff. And Mike, when things just didn't go his way, he always had a saying, I don't have any luck with you. So Ronnie, he used to say that to Ronnie once in a while, kind of bothered Ronnie a little bit. So anyway, Mike sent up his condolences and he said, well, congratulations to Keith very much, and Ronnie, I still never had any luck with you. So anyway, yeah. And Ronnie, we have a birthday, everybody has a birthday every year, but every year this goes, we're going to celebrate Ronnie's birthday. So this year again, we celebrated his 70th birthday. I said, this is 4 years in a row that we celebrated the 70th birthday. So, anyway, we've had a lot of fun, but you know, in all honesty, I mean, Ronnie was, he had a great set of hands. He, you're right, I mean, he was always in the right place at the right time, especially for big money. He always kind of wiggled his way up through them, but would upset a lot of big racing stuff. And it's an honor to race against him all these years, although I didn't see much of what he said, but I'm sure he was there. And a great trainer, great marshal, and a great guy, and you know, was willing to help anybody. And congratulations, Arnie. And to your driving with JJ's Metro that night, Roosevelt, that when he was allegedly interfered with, wasn't seven, John, it was six, there was only seven in there. He just crossed over in front of everybody. He thought, well, he stopped when he got to the rail. And it was a good bunch of horses, so when we came back to Johnny Chapman, he was pretty quick with it. Hector was in there, he said, I never bought anybody. So anyway, they take him down, and he was upset. He said, Hector, look on the bright side. If you ever come back here again and you leave, there'll be a hole for you. Thank you very much.